It's Minnie, and I'm back with a video. It's been about 2 years since I made a video. But we back, you know? Stuff happens, but I'm back now, so it's all that matters. But as you can see, we're going to do a natural beat today. Disclaimer, before I start, don't be bashing me, because I ain't no expert with makeup. So don't be expecting no... Like I said, this is going to be a natural beat. If you see me looking down, I'm looking at it. Yeah, so don't be found. I usually use NYX eyebrow pencil. Mine's broke, so. Well, I gotta get a new one. But I use the brush on it still, but I got another eyebrow pencil. I'm probably gonna speed this video up. So.
What is that?
Bacon, egg, cheese, sandwich, croissant looking.
Now, we're gonna go in with the LA Girl Pro Concealer. Cause this is the only stuff I use.
Bruh.
Okay, so I ain't gonna cap, but I feel like this video is boring. Like, I'm just saying, I'm like... Let's talk about toxic relationships. I feel like this is a topic for every female, to be honest, because we haven't been in one.
Well, you know, that's just like, your opinion, man.
Anyways, we are not a mistake in a relationship. I got a lot of stories to tell, to be honest, but I don't really tell people a lot about myself because I'm a pretty private person because I don't like posting my business.
Period.
But I guess I'll do it for the video. 2017, I started talking to this boy. He was like my crush at the time. But basically, it was ninth grade. And he went to my school, and I was like, he kind of cute.
Oh, here come that bullshit!
And I usually don't have crushes, but I don't. Like, I really don't, honestly. It's been.
Boy, if you don't.
But he ended up leaving for a second semester, so I'm like, where you go? We end up talking somehow. I want to say like that following year. Who was it?
2 hours later.
I'm trying to remember. It's been so long. I'm terrible at telling stories, man.
Hell yeah.
What happened was, I ended up telling my friend at the time that I had a crush on him, so she, like, I guess she, like, kind of put us on, you know what I'm saying? So, this was back when Kik was popping. I don't know if y'all know what Kik is, but back then, that was, like, the go-to, like, our iMessage chats. So, we ended up getting a chat with Kik.
And we started talking. It's like regular, basic shit. Not talking about shit, you know.
What you doing?
This was when Snapchat, like, started popping up, too. So we had got to Snapchat since then. Got on the phone a couple times. But we stopped talking for a while, and then we ended up talking again. Like, like, cause we wasn't serious at all. Chit chat. We started talking again one day. He Snapchat me. I was like, you know, the move to go hard. It was like the summertime, 2017, I think. So y'all don't get confused. We gonna call this boy Mike. So Mike Snapchat me one day. This is when I thought I was grown.
A woman feeling like a woman, looking like a woman.
So one day he was like, let's hang out.
You know what you did, Shane?
So, I went over to his house. I went over to Mike's house. And here's the catch. I am going by myself. I went with my best friend. She only a good person who didn't know about us. Because, like I said, I don't tell folks my business anymore. Anyways. My friend, she was downstairs. So we was watching Netflix for like a couple minutes. Then, you know, stuff got loose. Probably like an hour after that. His mama popped up at the house. And we end up having to sneak out. Got home or whatever. You know I'm happy. I'm like, ugh. Like I said, I thought I was grown. It's him. Nope. Doing grown folks stuff. But at the time, I didn't really have nobody watching over me like that. I was with my sister. So I just did whatever I wanted to do. She wasn't really paying attention to me most of the time anyway, so I just did whatever. I was out a lot that summer, so I started partying a lot. With Mike. And I ended up helping him with his business that same summer when he first started. Started his business. And it's to help him promote it, basically. Me and my friend. So, we went to all the little parties and stuff that summer. And, yeah, I'm terrible with telling stories. I'm terrible. This is really bad. This is really bad. Yeah, I was helping him with his business and stuff at the time. And we started becoming really close because we were from Arizona. But me, I shouldn't have got as comfortable as I did.
Watch it slow.
Knowing the fact that, you know, something could happen. But I was a child at the time. We all live and learn, right? I guess you could say me and Mike was like friends with benefits type thing. But he was the only person I was talking to, so of course, if I stop this video one more day, I'm gonna be frustrated with myself. Anyways, back to the story. We're talking for like a whole year. Look, you talking for a whole year. Of course you won't catch feelings. We wouldn't, like, really. But the catch is, we didn't date. So it was just like, what are y'all doing? Type of thing. So we was always getting into stuff. Just, you know how that go. Well, y'all don't date for real. But y'all be getting into arguments and stuff like y'all talk for real. Like, long story. You know how little boys are. Talking different females.
So, me, of course I ain't gonna cancel. Of course I didn't just talk to him after a while we took off. New plan, so I'm gonna play right along with you. Didn't nobody really know about us, to be honest. Only people who really know about us was his brother and we even went on a trip together and everything, so it's just like, of course you don't care spill it the work. So fake love, you know how that goes. It's a confused boy. It was a toxic ass relationship, honestly. You know, boys always come back. And of course, I was being dumb at the time. We all had our moments when we went back to somebody. I shouldn't, but anyways, the real reason why we stopped talking. This female hit me up on Instagram talking about some y'all talk ? And I'm like, remind you, I never posted anything about us talking or anything. It was like a video of a dancing or something. So this female hit me up talking about some y'all talk or whatever. And I'm just looking like, why? Like, that was your first question, right? I'm like, what is going on? Like, I don't know what's going on. I don't do drama, personally. Like, I don't like drama. I tend to stay away from drama. I'm gonna keep going because I'm over here. Okay. Y'all, it off. Hold up. I forgot the dang eyeshadow. Y'all, I don't buy expensive makeup because, honestly, I don't wear makeup. Most I do is my eyebrows. Really, I only do my makeup for, like, sometimes, you know, or if I'm playing in it. But, you know, but back to the story. After I was like, wow, whatever, she got all hype at me.
Bitch, what?
Cause if you don't, when I see you, I'm gonna beat your ass, bitch.
So, I asked her if she had pressure or whatever. I'm like, what you getting hype at me for? I'm like, you acting like I done did something to you. I don't remember the messages, message by message, but she was, the way she came at me was like she had a problem. So I'm just looking like, she was like a year young. When niggas talk to me, you know, anything, they're like, they gonna talk to me. So basically, we was calling the whole little scene or whatever, making it seem like she had pressure. And I'm like, you really finna argue with me over this nigga. So I went to him, who's this girl? Cause she's in my DM. Asking all these questions and I don't even know her. He was basically just telling me like, oh, she nobody and all this other stuff. He was lying. He was going back and forth lying to both of us or whatever. And at that point, I'm just like, I don't even care no more, to be honest.
You capping!
You calling me, trying to explain, sounding dumb.
You could do.
I'm just like, you might as well keep your little eye. I did a base color on my eye. I don't know if y'all can see. It's like a brown. Like, I don't know what you call it. I'm gonna go on it. Some more concealer to put like a second coat. I don't know this makeup. Oh yeah, back to the story. He was just lying to both of us because she over here talking about one thing and he told me another thing. So, trying to make her look delusional. But the girl had proof. She had pictures for him. I'm just like,
really, nigga?
I wasn't home for the shit no more. So she started trying to like ban me and stuff. I don't know. How you gonna ban me from some shit? After that, we stopped talking for a while. And then, like, I wanna say a couple of weeks later, he hit me up. And of course, my dumbass was talking to him, being a child. Stuff was not. It just wasn't. He changed. I'm just gonna say it like that. He changed. And y'all, I'm using, it's called Peachy for my, I'm using that one for my top coat. He was just different. Like, he just wasn't the same. I was just like, this ain't the Mike I know. So, Mike was doing his little party stuff, hanging with all these different females and stuff, so I'm just like, I don't want to do this no more. Like, why keep pretending, honestly? Then New Year's came, I ain't gonna cap. Me and my other friend, we're gonna call her Sarah. I was close with her and she helped with the party stuff too.
Pause!
Obviously I'm everywhere with this story already. And I'm taking forever with this makeup.
We're on a backup to when I was like only his brother and about us. Yeah. So basically
Sarah turned her back on me too.
Him and his brother made him fairly younger. We end up becoming close or whatever. But turned out the bitch was fake.
I'm ready to get the fuck ASAP!
I'm just leaving it at that. I'm not gonna speak down at her because she was my friend at one point. Fast forward to New Year's. Me and my friend Mo went to get that. That they had. So Sarah drove us to the party. And that night, I ain't gonna cap. I was lit.
About a week ago, Fuck with us and then we tweaking, run up.
But Sarah ain't there. But basically what happened was Sarah became friends with the enemy. The girl that she knew I was in cool with. And she knew what happened a while ago. So to me, for her to start being friends with her, I'm like, okay, what's going on type thing. So I confronted her about it. The first time I noticed or whatever, she was like, nah, it's not like that. All this other stuff. It's just business. Because we were doing promotion. So I wasn't really tripping. So I let it go. Because I'm just that person. I'm not gonna be, oh my god. Really? Y'all can't even see, but my feelings is hurt right now.
I look your ass.
If you was my friend, even if I mean on the phone, FaceTime calls and stuff, I'm just like, okay. So I stopped stop talking to her like that. And then she started questioning me why I wasn't messing with her like that no more. And I'm just like,
you tough? And you tough?
Really, nigga?
So basically, the other time they came around, this was after the fact. And then me and Michael weren't talking anymore. But she was still cool with it anyway. So basically, we went somewhere like a day or two before Valentine's together, and it was some business stuff. But basically, she decided she wanted to give me a Valentine's box. I wasn't thinking about getting no gifts for nobody or anything, but she wanted to give me a gift because she wanted a gift. I was just like, okay. So I accepted the gift. You know, I was happy, but I'm not the type of person. Like, no matter how big or small the gift is, it's just the thought that counts to me. Like, I don't care, to be honest. So, basically, after I got the gift, I watched her Snapchat the 2 days later. I was going there, and she basically went all out for Valentine's Day. But anyway, you swear up and down when you were this close to this girl. This is what she got me before I named her. She got me, it was like a canister type thing that had like a Valentine's
stuff on it, whatever.
And it was like candy inside. I think it was a card, chewing, and like some tacos from Taco Bell. Yeah, she was more. I didn't care what she got me, to be honest, because it was just really the thought that counted to me. But the fact that you went all out for the enemy, and I'm supposed to be your friend, and we've been friends way longer, mind you. And you've been friends with this girl for a month
or two.
And you got her a big ass teddy bear. That shit not cheap. And then y'all went out to eat together. So I'm just like, what the hell? I'm like, and I think she got her a pillow or something. I don't know. But supposed to be my friend, like, I'm confused. So I don't. What's the story? This is why I don't get close to people like that anymore or make new friends like that, because people really put on my face or do stuff just to be seen, as I want to say. And I'm not like that, because I don't care. I don't care if you see me, to be honest. If you see me, you do. If you don't, oh well. Like, that's just me. Like, I'm not gonna be all up in nobody's face. I'm not a clout chaser. I don't do that stuff. So, I just thought it was really cool all of them all together. My little story time, I guess. But I'm gonna finish this makeup.
Show y'all after the vote.
good joke. Yeah, that is it for this video, you guys. Go ahead and give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Yeah, I will be dropping more videos about my business and all the other good stuff. But until then, go ahead and subscribe. Drop a comment too if you want to see something. Give me an idea or something. But yeah, other than that, team, we out. Yiddy. Bye.